Hello guys, welcome to journal entry number one of the Lifestyle Academy that I'm doing right now. I just want to keep a nice journal entry of what I've been doing and what my progression throughout the next 3 months of taking this this lifestyle course. I just went through week one. Week one was basics, just going through the whole curriculum of what we're going to be doing over the next 8 weeks. So basically we have to create what is called a man operating system, man OS, that Brad told us to do. So we had to create values. So we had to pick values, things we value the most, at least 8 to 12 of them. And then we have to write our vision, what we want out of each value. We had to write the purpose and why we want those values. And we had to write goals that we're going to have so that we can reach those values. And he told us to be very specific on it. He told us it'll probably be a little hard the first few weeks to be specific. Most of us would be a little broad. When I wrote mine, it was probably very broad. Like the first three, I went into detail. And then towards the like eighth and ninth one, it started getting less and less and less because I realized like those are things that I don't value as much as the three on top. Those are like the ones I care about the most, and probably the ones that are in the forefront of my mind all the time. So my nine values, I chose nine. I go through them in order. It's money, knowledge. Hold on. Health and fitness, spirituality. I'm just gonna hold my computer here. Five is travel and fun. Six is family. Seven are relationships, girls. Eight are friends. And nine is sex. So basically, the reason why I chose to do this is because I've noticed I have a lot of issues with procrastination, so I decided to take some action and be like, I'm done. I really don't want to work the corporate life. I really want to work on my own terms, have an online business, or at least work, if I do work in a career, at least something that's more free and allows me to travel more, so I have more time to see the world, because that's something I really want to do. And that's like the ultimate vision, like travel, see the world, meet amazing people from around the world. These are things that I want to do. I want to go on adventures. I want to try different things, see different cultures, do all this. That's something I really, really want to do. Now, those are my core values because these are things that I probably think about on a day-to-day throughout the day. So, like, number one, I chose money. The reason why money, it's not really a big value because of the power of money and how it's fake is really just an idea. It's something that keeps us, you know, in line. Like, oh, we have to follow. This is the new trade. Like, we don't barter anymore and do anything or trade something for something. We do trade. We trade a dollar that's of value for our product. But I see it more as financial freedom. I want financial freedom. So how I put it is my vision for financial freedom is basically my vision is this. I want to be making maximum of $20,000 a month. Now, I'm not asking to make millions because I really don't need millions with the lifestyle I want to live. I don't need anything fancy, a car, anything. As I said earlier, I want to travel. So I'm not going to have a car and I'm not going to have a house. I'm going to be traveling a lot. And I want to be able to make that money virtually. So that means working on my computer, whether that's a freelance business, a career that involves me traveling, maybe selling something to different countries, whatever the case is. I thought about doing some web design and maybe have an online business where I sell a product. So I'm actually starting because I want to have freelance. I want to have something I can freelance. So I'm going to start web design this week. That's my main focus right now. I already created an account with hackdesign.com where they basically give you a goal like every week or every day. I don't remember. But they give you a goal every week or every day and I just have to complete the goal and it's like an ongoing thing. So like it goes from beginner to intermediate to about expert. So my next 6 months will be focused on mastering this. After that, my second thing is to start my online business. I'm going to actually take a course with Tim's Freedom Business on his website. So he basically teaches you how to create a freedom business so I can work anywhere. So I'm going to do that, and hopefully my ultimate goal is by 26, I at least have an income coming in residually about $3,000 a month, so I can quit my corporate job and just focus on that, and then I can start my travels. You know, I'm going to just start small, probably go around the U.S., and then I'll start traveling when I start getting a little more money and I have other people working for me. So that's one of my biggest things. And I'm just giving a brief summary of this because if I go through it, it'll be too long. That Man OS is about 8 pages long, and it's only going to get longer as the weeks go by. So that's it. And my purpose, of course, is have more money, have more freedom. The more money I have, the more I can help people, because that's the ultimate goal, to create a nice foundation so I can really do what I want, which is make these videos for people in relationships. So that's my first thing. Let me just look here. And second thing I'm doing, I put knowledge, or you can say it's what I want to learn the most, which is web design. So I'm pretty much very knowledgeable in a lot of things, but I want to gain more skills that can be transferable, whether that's transferable skills in a day-to-day basis, not from job to job, just something I can use no matter what. If I lose a job, I have these skills that I can use to make myself money even though I don't have a job. And the purpose of it is so that I can better myself and I can also help others. So maybe somebody that wants to learn, I can be a mentor to somebody in the future when I get older. I mean, who wants to be a mentee of a 24-year-old, right? But with this, I'll be reading more books. I'll be doing the online courses. I'll be listening to more audios and read day-to-day articles on anything that I'm interested in. But this is just knowledge in general, which I pretty much, this is something I'll be doing for the rest of my life. It's reading books, gaining as much knowledge, learning as much as possible, and things of, you know, philosophy, psychology, different kinds of sciences, and relationships is something that I'm really into. So I'll be doing that more often. Number three is health and fitness. This is something I've been focused on for the past few years. I'm really big on like fitness and eating healthy. I try to stay away from things like red meat. I don't eat fast food too much, and if I do, I try to make the healthiest choice as possible. So you won't see me at a McDonald's unless I'm maybe getting a grilled chicken wrap if I'm on the go and I really have to go quick. I don't eat no burgers from outside at all. If I do eat a burger, it's probably from like a diner or something where it's fresh, you know, they actually make it, like take the meat, put it, it's not frozen patty. But aside from that, my vision is to have my idol, somebody that I look up to, because it's the same kind of body I want. It's not muscular, but it's lean. It's Ryan Gosling. So look at him. He's not muscular, but he's lean. So I decided that I need to work out 6 days a week. That's my goal. And so I got to do cardio, 3 days cardio flexibility, 3 days strength training, and prep food more often instead of eating outside. Prep more veggies, have more fruits, have more lean meat, have more nuts, healthy fats, drink more water, especially lemon water, which is very helpful. And of course, for that reason, my purpose in this is to be more energetic and be able to be more productive and rest easier, because I have trouble sleeping, so I think that will help. Number four is spirituality. My vision is to be more grounded and collected. So I'm pretty spiritual. I just want to be more calm, more being able to be more emotional intelligent. I believe that connects with spirituality on some point. I want to do more meditation because I feel like that will make me more spiritual. And I do want to learn about different religions and culture, even though I'm not really religious. But it's good to know the cultures and different kinds of religions, so you kind of get an aspect. And you know, if you talk to anyone on religion, they won't be like, oh, you just don't believe in it. So I'm going to read more books on spirituality, meditate more, definitely, so I can have more clear thinking. I'll be able to articulate my thoughts much more clearly. Number five is travel and fun, which I think I'm going to change. I might put that more, much more higher on my list, because it's really what I want to do. I want to be able to travel when I want, whenever I want, and have fun while doing it, whether that's with somebody, alone, or visiting maybe a friend in another country. That would be pretty cool. So I see myself traveling all around the world for pretty much my whole life. I'll probably come back, you know, for a few years, make a family, and then after my family grows older, you know, kids grow older, I'm back on it again. But at least in my young years, I want to be able to do more adventures, like go cliff diving and go zip lining in some forest and go hiking up this mountain and maybe hike a little bit of Mount Everest, do crazy stuff like that. And that's my purpose, is to be able to have stories when I get older for my kids and my grandkids. I want them to see me as cool. I want to be the cool granddad, you know? And I also put a quote that really sticks to me all the time, Explore, Dream, Discover by Mark Twain. So my goal for the next few months is to travel a little bit more. So do like mini vacations, you know, explore different states, cities, try new things. And I can do that. It doesn't really have to be expensive with things like couch surfing or Airbnb. And all I really need is money for like food and travels and the activities I want to do. Number six is family. I put it pretty low because I have really good relationships with my family, so it's not something I have to work on. So I'm putting it in a maintenance mode, something that Brad made up where you put it on the side and you like you work on it a little bit. So it's like I visit my family once a week or once every 2 weeks whenever I can. I think I'm good, but I do have a baby brother that I do adore. He's like a son of my own. And I do want to see him grow up. I do want to, you know, be there when he first goes to school, pre-K. I want to be there when he graduates. I want to be there. So obviously, if I make more money and I have more of the financial freedom, I have the time to be able to go to all these places. Even if I'm in another country, I'll know ahead of time he's going to graduate. So of course, I'll come back to the Americas, watch him graduate, stay some time, spend some time with him, and then go back to my traveling. That's something I want to do. And of course I value my family immensely because they've been there my whole life, and my mother is a single mother growing up. And she pretty much taught me a lot that I know and made me the person that I am, you know. I'm not gonna get into that too personal. Anyway, number seven is girls and relationships. You can always get better. I'm happy with where I am right now when it comes to relationships. I'm still gonna game so that I can actually keep my skills, even though it's like riding a bike. I don't do it for a long time, but once you get back out there and you start getting the ball rolling again, it all comes back to you like this. But I do want to continue gaming. Right now I can't, I just choose not to put my energy there, especially now that I'm focused on LSA, then I have the two jobs. It's just too much. So right now my goal is to start gaming at least once a week, or at least in 20 minutes a day, maybe one approach, anything, so that I can add more to my harem in the future. So when I have more time, I can basically travel, maybe travel with these girls, you never know. Number eight, I put friends, because I feel like my friends know what I'm doing. They won't really be upset that I haven't hung out with them, right? We haven't had a bro night, or I haven't seen my friends that are girls in a long time. They don't really care because they know that I'm doing something with my life. I'm trying to be somebody one day, you know? And I want more successful friends, so I want to have friends that are, create a mastermind group with friends with similar attitude. So LSA is a great place for that, so I'm going to hopefully meet some people there. I have 8 weeks, so this is going to be pretty cool. So I'm going to use LSA. Also just signed up with escapethecity.org. There's a lot of people there with the same mindset since I just finished this book. Let me just show you. Might be interested in reading the Escape Manifesto, Quit Your Corporate Job and Do Something Different. Great book. Great stories, amazing quotes, a lot of good value in it, a lot of websites and people to follow that if you want to escape, see what you want to do. Your escape could be escape a job for another job or escape the corporate life like I want to. So I'm going to meet some people probably on there, but those people mostly live in Europe. That was me. These guys are from London. Number nine, I use sex because I do want to get better. I want to be able to make my girls orgasm and have the best kinds of orgasms. And my purpose is to make them do it multiple times and being able to have more stamina in the bed. In the bed. And make them squirt. So I have to read Multi-Orgasmic Man to learn how to control my own orgasms and possibly learn how to have multiple orgasms. Apparently this is a thing. And I want to check out White Tiger Tantra, which I hear a lot of guys talk about. And it's like massaging, getting the girl comfortable, and then you just make them squirt ridiculously, which is pretty cool. So not too much I wrote there because obviously it's very basic and simple. But I do want girls to enjoy that. So I'll be doing these videos more often, maybe once a week, maybe twice a week, depending on what goes on, how excited I get. I'm definitely going to make a video when I do meet with Brad. Since I bought the silver package, I get 2 one-on-ones with him. So once I get the one-on-ones with him, I will create a video to say like what it was like. And this is for my personal journal. But if anyone watches this, I hope you gain something out of it. That would be pretty cool. So enjoy the rest of your night or day. And take care.